Peace. What's cracking with the boxing world? It's the King Legendary Top Cat. Hey, man, we back with another one, man. Feel me? Hey, man, you know, this the grind series. You feel me, man? This shit all about the grind, man. It's all about the journey. So let us know, what's your purpose? What you grinding for, man? What motivated this shit?
What motivate me is how my parents, how my coach, how everybody put into me. I just want to get back. Like, I'm not going to be satisfied until my family is like fed, like they don't have to want for nothing.
You only fuck with the drip. Dirty dumb. By the time the world get acquainted, nigga.
I had to boss up for a check. I had to step on these nigga neck. I had to go and get a couple strikes. I had to trap all day and night. I remember them cold nights. I hit a lock, I just got out the pen. I buy a brick, then I go get it in. I'm a boss, I can override you. Come here, girl, let me get inside you. Come here, girl, let me jump behind you. Play with me and I'ma come and find you. I had to go and get a couple strikes. I had to trap all day and night. I had to boss up for a check. I had to step on these nigga neck. I had to boss up for a check. I had to shoot a nigga for respect. I had to step on these nigga next. Did to show these niggas I got next. I went and put that gold on my neck.
Hey, man, we back with another one, man, in the grind series, man. We really, really get it out the mud, man. We following these amateurs and these pros' careers, man, on this journey. We're really, really getting it out the mud, man. I got my homie Marlo's Kona with me today.
What's good, fam? What's good, everybody? What's good, champ?
Man, we got Rough House Boxing in this bitch. Man, we got the champ, one and only, man, Nick Sullivan in this motherfucker. What's up with it, King?
What's up with you, man?
This is good, fam.
Hey, this a bad motherfucker right here, man. Hey, tell the people where you from, huh?
Man, I'm from Norfolk, Virginia. I train out of Norfolk, Virginia.
Turn up, man. Shout out to Virginia, man.
The champ is here.
Shout out Sweet Pete, man.
Yeah, Sweet Pete.
In a real, real way, man. Norfolk getting it in, man. Hey, somebody told us the other day, man, I don't know what's in that Norfolk water, man, but Virginia beat them niggas fighting like a motherfucker out of Virginia, man.
Yeah. I'm from originally from Portland, but I'm always out in Norfolk because that's where I train at.
Already. Yeah. Goes down in Norfolk.
Yeah, it do.
Marlo Turner, hey, let the people know what weight class you fight at.
I fight at 138. Now, it was 141, but USA Boxing changed the weight classes, so I'm fighting at 138 now.
No, he said he rolling heads at 138. That's what he said.
For real, though.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
All right, fam, we're going to jump right on in it, man. Let the people know who and what got you into the sport of boxing.
Well, actually, I was playing other sports, so... one day, one of the coaches came past my mother's shop. My mom got her own hair salon and was letting us know about the boxing program. And, you know, me as a little kid, a little boy, you know, fighting, that's just fun to me. So I always wanted to try it. And so she told about that, and my mama threw me in a little boxing program, and I just stuck with it since.
That's what's up. Enjoyed it. Let me follow that up then. What you like most about the sport so far? You know what I'm saying?
I like it now because I'm making a career out of it. But younger, I just like the traveling part. Get to travel, fight. Sometimes get to be out of school. It was just
Hey, you get that free skip day. That's what's up.
Yeah. Hey, and you get to see a lot. You get to see a lot of things. You know, that's cool though. That's what's up.
That is true. Traveling state to state at a young age was just fun.
Yeah. Real talk.
What's the livest place you ever traveled to?
The livest place? I would have to say it's a tie between Cali and Reno.
Hey, give us a little, and I know you something like a hometown hero, celebrity, whatever, you know what I'm saying? Everybody know who the young hit is, you know what I'm saying, out there in Norfolk, man. So tell us a little bit about the support you get from your hometown.
Man, the support come from giving back, you know what I'm saying? Once you give the people hope, they're going to always give back it to you. It's not always about, you know what I'm saying, doing it for the people. Like, just to put your city on your back, it's just a great feeling. They give back it to you once you see you giving it to them.
That's a fact.
Yeah. Already. Hey, well, check this out. I'm going to backdoor that question with this, man. I heard you mention your trainer just a second ago. Yeah. So we're still on your origin. Who was your first trainer? And then describe him for the people out there that's listening.
Coach Sean Wilson. he talked right. about boxing all in the same time. Like, it's a lot that I learned from him. It's more than just boxing. But what about after boxing? You always gonna want right. to be remembered. And you play an impact on people's lives outside the ring just as much as you do inside the ring.
Real talk. Yeah. Real talk.
Hey, everybody, hey, that's only when they special, though, little homie. You hear me? You feel me? Because everybody don't have that power.
Yes, sir. Been together since I was 8.
Yeah, that's a bond. That's a bond.
Shout out, Coach.
Shout out, Coach.
Yeah. Man, you know, this the grind series, you feel me, man? This shit all about the grind, man. It's all about the journey. Motherfucker don't see you out there running. Motherfucker don't know when you out there working hard and what this shit really take, man. So let us know, what's your purpose? What you
grind? What motivate me is how my parents, how my coach, how everybody put into me. I just want to get back. Like, I'm not going to be satisfied until my family is, like, fed. Like, they don't have to want for nothing.
Mm.
I do this for me, but I also do it for my family, too.
Man, that's lost.
That's what's up. Man. Real talk. Hey, got people depending on him. That's what's up.
Got people depending on me. Like, yeah. I got a brother that's in a wheelchair. He was born with cancer. He can't really do much. So he lived his life through me. So that's another motivation from me right there.
What's his name, fam? Hey. You don't mind me asking.
Yeah.
We call him CJ, but his name Christopher.
Shout out to Christopher, man.
You know what I'm saying? That's what's up, man. Salute to you from the whole block, fam. Chris, CJ.
Appreciate that. If he heard that, he probably be smiling right now.
All right, we're gonna stay on your grind though, man. When you in there working, man, you in there really focused. Tell us what punches you work on the most.
Well, my coach actually, the jab is the key to success and to any boxer. You need that. You won't be successful without a jab. Jab set up everything. So I would say the jab I would work on the most.
That's right. So let me follow up with this. What combination would you say you're confident about?
Right now, I would say probably the 1-2-3 come to the body.
Pain.
Knock the wind out of the head.
You know what I'm saying? Hey, you said...
My coach, I promise, my shoulders be feeling like I'm about to fall off in the gym. I work on one combination almost every day.
Let me ask you this. In your opinion, what is the hardest style of fighter to prepare for?
I would say the hardest style fighter to prepare for would be someone that fight like me, a boxer. Mm. Because pressure fighters, they easy because they're coming. So they're going to run into most of the punch-up. I would say a boxer like me because now it's more than just boxing. It's a chess match.
Real talk.
It's who can outthink who first and the fastest.
Okay. That's what's up. We got your strength, man. What if you could improve one area of your game, what do you think that one area would be?
If I could improve one area of my game, I would probably say stick it to the game plan. Sticking to the gameplay because stuff like that, it doesn't throw me off, but it gets in my head. It's like he making the dog fight. Now I feel like I'm down. Now I feel like I'm losing. Now I feel like I got to do something to come back and win the fight. But whole time, I'm in there looking from the outside in. My coach telling me he's not really doing nothing. He's just trying to make it a dog fight. But in my head, I'm thinking I'm losing.
Real talk. That's what's up.
Because he tried to be more aggressive, so you feeling like you got to step it up, huh?
You know what I'm saying? Hey, he trying to get that get back.
All right, give us some long-term and short-term goals in boxing for you right now, fam.
Well, short-term goals is I got to fight the 23rd, and I got the Olympic qualifiers in March, and I plan to take those windows, which I should. I went to take those tournaments. Long-term goals. I'm shooting for the 2020 Olympics. And after that, to turn pro and just be the best boxer that ever lived. Like,
you said you got a fight on the 23rd, man. Where you fighting at?
We heard the Richmond, Virginia part.
You said Richmond, Virginia?
Yeah, on February 23rd.
Okay. You already got an opponent lined up?
Yeah, I'm fighting somebody from West Virginia.
Okay, from you fighting from West Virginia. Okay, that's what's up. Hey, got a state to state rivalry going on. That's what's up.
Yeah.
All right. Hey, well, check this out. I want to ask you a little something. You know what I'm saying? You as a fan, bro.
Yeah.
I want to know. I'm gonna put you on the spot right now.
Okay.
If you could sit ringside for any fight, past or present, mm-hmm. what fight would it be and why?
Past or present.
Yeah,
I gotta pick one, or it could be two.
Yeah, it could be two.
Okay, so if I had to sit ringside for a fight, it would be Pernell and Chavez, and Floyd and Madonna.
Ooh wee, yeah, that's two headbangers right there, man. That's two good fights.
Yeah,
that's what's
which
up, man.
One? Which Floyd and Madonna?
The second time he just outclassed. I would say the first time.
Yeah. That first, okay.
Yeah, see how you work through that adversity. That's what's up, man. Yeah. Hey, well, check this out. I want to run this back. I want to ask you this.
What's up?
Describe to me, and keep it a buck with me. Hey, I want you to describe your most satisfying win. I mean, I want the one where, you know what I'm saying, it just felt good to beat that nigga's ass. You know, so beat the brakes off that nigga. What was your most satisfying win?
My most satisfying win, I would have to say the Gold Glove semifinal.
All right.
Because it was just like this dude that I fought in the semifinals just was, he was running through everybody throughout the tournament. I seen him fight the day before me, and he ran through the dude. So I was like, oh, yeah, I got a tough fight come semifinals time. And then I got in there with a mindset like, oh, this is about to be a dog fight. But my coach gave me a game plan, came out victorious, and that was just one of the wins. Like I'm glad I got that win. Like that gave me a lot of confidence.
Oh man, hey man, we're gonna turn up, man. We're gonna get real, real quick on our toes, man. I know you fast than a motherfucker, so I know you can better keep up, goddamn. All right, I'm gonna ask you a few questions. And shit, I want the first thing that come to your mind.
Okay.
All right, turn up. If you can live anywhere in the world other than your hometown, where would it be?
Vegas.
You know saying? You want the lights.
Hey, so I'm breaking down. I'll go down. Tell us why Vegas.
Vegas is just like, no matter what time of day or night, it's just lit out there. Like, that's just the definition of lifestyle out there.
Hey, some bad bitches out there, too. Keep it gangster. They got something to do with it, too, man.
Hey.
That's what's up.
Okay.
Hey, that's a fact. Hey. That's a fact.
All right. I say short women or tall women.
I mean, if she bad, it don't even matter.
Nah, that's what I'm talking about. That's what I like to hear right there.
Yeah.
Hey, bro, you don't know how many people come on here, they be like, short. Man, what about them bad tall ones?
All your homies on Team USA, they all of them like short women.
Hey, man, hey, go ahead and climb that tree, Nick. That's what I'm talking about.
Pound for pound, dead or alive, give us your top three.
Oh, that's easy. Pernell, Floyd, and Andre Ward.
Already.
Okay. All right. Hey, you be fucking with basketball?
Yeah, I do that from time to time as a cardio.
Oh yeah. Who your team?
Y'all gonna say I'm a bandwagon, but I rock with Golden State.
Hey, that's all right. Hey, this
ain't mad at you at all, man. They got
them boys is the truth out there right now.
Yeah, they is.
Real talk.
Hey, let me tell you something, little Nick. A real nigga told me one day, hey, man, you surround yourself with winners, man, you win. You know
what I'm saying? That's a fact. That's why I like them.
Real talk.
They will do whatever it take to win.
All right, well, tell me this since we on that topic. Who the GOAT, MJ or LeBron?
Man, I would say MJ overall, but LeBron for his time.
Okay, okay. LeBron,
give me
the GOAT just for his time.
Hey, whoa, 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 whoa. Time out, top. Hold up, man. I ain't gonna let him make it on that one. I gotta know.
Okay, hey, check it out. Get it. I was gonna let him make it.
Hey, check this out. Hey, Nick, if you had to start you a franchise right now, NBA franchise, and you had to pick one or the other, which one are you gonna start your franchise with, MJ or LeBron?
Ah, that's tough. That's tough. I'm gonna have to go with Michael Jordan though.
Okay. Yeah, but ain't no wrong answer. It's your franchise. Ain't no wrong answer.
Yeah. I'm gonna have to go with Michael Jordan. Yeah, that's a tough decision.
Watch this from here, man. I hope I don't get you in trouble, man. You can't let baby hear this shit, man. What's up? But give me your first three celebrity crush. Your top three celebrity crush.
Oh, that is Lauren London. That's number one.
Shut up.
Lauren London. I forgot the girl that sang. The girl that sang Boot Up.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Ella Mai. Yeah. I ain't forgetting. Goddamn, that's Ella Mai.
I forgot the girl name.
What she look like?
Top three would be Lauren London, the girl that sang Boot Up, and Jennifer Lopez. Jennifer Lopez, I don't care how old she gets, she gonna always look good.
That's what's up.
He wants some of that wet. That's fight.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, that motherfucking wagon dragging.
Some of that.
He's in the trunk.
Some of that I my me.
Xbox and PlayStation.
You said what?
Xbox and PlayStation.
Well, I personally got a PlayStation, but either one I rock with.
Okay. Favorite movie of all time. I'm talking about you can watch that whole back to back.
Friday.
Which one?
All right.
The first one. The very first one.
Okay.
Yeah. That's what's up. Classic.
Smokey taking the shit. I ain't gonna tell nobody else.
As what's up.
Hey, watch this here. When you ain't out there on the grind, when you turn it down from the grind, goddamn, and you ain't gotta worry about making weight and shit. What's your favorite food to eat?
Oh, lasagna, spaghetti and stuff like that.
Okay, you like Italian shit, goddamn.
Yeah.
That's what's up.
Already.
Yeah, it is on you, Marlo.
All right. I'm about to finish. I got this last one for you, champ.
What's up?
I lace my game after who?
My boxing game?
Yeah.
I would have to say Pernell.
Sweet P. Shout out Sweet P. Yeah.
Them combinations, huh? Walk up on him, huh?
Yeah. I get a lot of my stuff how I fight in the ring from him. He paved the way, and we just gotta walk that path and make it long.
That's right, man. We with you too.
Yeah, like a motherfucker on that grind.
I'm gonna bust you in the head, but you ain't gonna touch me. That's what I'm talking about.
Turn it rough.
All right, that's what's up. Hey, check this out. We're gonna play a little game, man. It's called Finish the Sentence. All right. I'm gonna start the sentence, and then you end it with whatever comes to mind. You ready?
Okay. Yeah.
All right, here we go. If I wasn't a boxer, I'd be a
ball player.
Ball player. Football, basketball, what?
Basketball.
Okay, that's what's up. All right. Hey, the most difficult thing about boxing is?
Making weight.
Man. Hey, bro, I swear just about every cat that come on here say that, man. Hey, talk to me a little bit about maintaining your weight and keeping weight and making weight and all that.
Man, I promise you, boxing would be the best sport ever if we did not have to cut weight. That... Like, I be so irritated when I be losing weight. Like, it's just like, it's so much. Like, you want to eat the whole world when you lose weight. Like, it's just, but you gotta stay dedicated. It's really a mindset thing. If you tell your mind you could do it, you could do it. But yeah, it's a headache sometimes. Like, you eat, like me personally, I eat a big breakfast. Won't really eat nothing for lunch. Go to the gym, workout. Then I eat like a piece of fruit or little baked chicken and a salad. I get on the diet, but you know you're used to eating whatever and whenever, so you really like you want to eat. Like, it's just a headache. And then when fight time come and it's getting close to fight time and you're not really close to weight, then that's when you really got to put on, like, the sauna suit. You be so hot, so sweaty. Like, it's just a headache.
That's what's up. Hey, so it'd be messed up if, like, you was getting ready to have a fight and then I sent you a picture of some homemade lasagna. That'd be messed up, huh? That'd be salty.
Man, I wouldn't even open the three.
That's what's up. Already.
Open it, John.
Hey, I wouldn't do you like that, champ. You know what I'm saying?
You notice when boxers get off the scale, they got like Pedialyte. They got a piece of fruit. They can't wait to get off that scale.
Right.
And when they go eat, they punish. But you can't eat too much because if you're in a tournament, you got to do the same thing again the next day.
Real talk.
Wow.
That's what's up. All right, we get on to the next one then. All right, my biggest cheerleader is
my mother.
Hey, shout out to Ma Dukes.
Yeah, shout out to
salute moms. Yeah,
appreciate
that's
that.
What's up. Raising a real one. All right, well, check this out. When I get my first paycheck as a pro, I'm gonna buy
my coach and mother. And my coach, mother, and father, something they always wanted is like, it's not always about me. They put so much into me, I got to give back. And that's something I just want to do.
Already.
My first paycheck.
Man, that's okay. Love, man.
Yeah. That's what's up, man. Hey, this dude keep talking about giving back, man. I like that about him, bro.
Yeah.
I like that. You know what I'm saying? I think we're going to have a real one right here on our hands right here. Mm. That's what's up. All right. We get into this one. My all-time favorite pair of shoes is
Air Max. Well, it's a tie between Air Max and Jordans.
Okay, which J's? Which ones?
I would say the 12s.
12s. All right, that's yeah. What's up, man. That's a good pair.
Yeah.
Already. All right. My favorite pair of boxing gloves are, or favorite brand of boxing gloves are,
Winning Gloves.
Winning. Hey, he the second one in a row that said those winnings, man.
Yeah.
The winnings must go pretty hard. What you like about those?
Like, they comfortable, and I like the fact that it say winning. Like, I don't want to center myself around anything winning.
That's right. What's up. Already. Okay, the biggest way boxing has changed my life is?
The biggest way boxing changed my life would be Me staying focused and dedicated, because I could get sidetracked real fast. And boxing just, I don't know, it just changed my life for the better. I just feel like I'm a better person since I've been boxing.
Already. You know what I'm saying? Can't do nothing but respect that.
Real All right,
just the last one, bro. The one thing that I want people to know about me the most is
that I do it for my city and my family.
Real talk. He put on for his city. Hey, VA is in the building. You know what I'm saying? Norfolk, stand up.
Stand up. Hey, who are some other people we should be looking out for, man?
Well, we got a lot of upcoming fighters in our gym. We got we call him Boomer, but his real name, Anthony Boomer, but he upcoming fighter. We got a lot of youngins in the gym. Yeah. So we got a lot of upcoming fighters out of our gym.
Tell Ant we want to holler at him, man. Bring shoot him a shot, man. Let him know we want to holler at him, man. We'll bring him on the show.
I'll send him a text and let him know y'all trying to interview him.
Bet.
Real talk.
Yeah, I'll let him know. I'm on the way back home now, so I'll let him know when I see him. He should be in the gym today.
Yeah, tell him you put that word in, man. We want to holler at him.
Okay, I got you.
You know what I'm saying? Get him over here on the block with the block fam. That's what's up.
Yeah, I'm going to let him know. Probably be excited.
Already.
Hey, man. Hey, Nick, a 9-time national champion around this motherfucker, man. Hey, let him know.
9 times? Hello, you said 9 times?
Yeah, 9.
The one after
motherfucking 10
times mine. 10 this year.
I was just finna say that he's about to be the big 1-0. You know what I'm saying? Think he working for nothing, goddamn me?
Man. Hold up, dog. You said 9, nigga. Just 9?
Hey, that's a lot of ass whoopers, man.
Ooh, wee. Real talk.
Hey, you done whooped a lot of niggas' ass, Nick. Hey, I got like 100 and... around this motherfucker. One junior world champion. Hey, man, this nigga the choke, man. Young King, man. Young Nick, man. Straight out of Norfolk, Virginia, man. Hey, appreciate your time, man. This shit is real, man.
Hey, legendary. He said he had over 100 and what?
I got like 119 fights.
Get him.
God damn. That's what's up.
Damn.
Man, I'm still tripping on that 9-time national champion. God, hey.
Hey, y'all, he's still focused. He's still focused. He trying to get to that 2020 Olympics.
Ain't nobody else eating in his division. He says, mine. Give it here.
That's the mindset you got to have.
That's what's up.
Man. Hey, we with you on the journey over here on the grind, man. We with you the whole way, man. Hey, Ruff, man, before we get out of here, you got to let them know, man.
Man, hey, check this out. Hey, Nick. I'm going to keep it a buck with you, bro. Right now, what's man, up? Hey, I ain't going to tell you nothing but what the Lord love. That's the truth, bro.
Yeah.
When you get to the Nationals.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying? You win that. You know what I'm saying? When you make it to Tokyo 2020, you get in there and you get that gold. And you know what I'm saying? They got you on the stand.
Yeah.
When I'm in my living room watching. I'm going to jump over and I'm going to tell everybody in the house, that's my nigga right there. I know that nigga. Hey, that's fam right there, bro. That's my people.
Don't let them let me get the mic, man. I'm shouting
man,
out.
Look.
I'm shouting out the block fam.
Already.
All that.
That's what's up.
Real, hey. That's love, man.
That's love, man. Hey, appreciate that. Hey, but hey, we with you on the journey, bro. Hey, we rooting for you. You know what I'm saying? Hey, let us know when you got stuff in the mix, okay. Any events you got going on, fights,
yeah.
Merchandise, whatever, man. We're going to promote it. We're going to pump it. We're going to put it out to the people and let them know, man.
Okay, that's I send y'all a few stuff after this interview. I'll send you a few.
Okay. Real talk.
Yeah, we can put that together, man. Hey, let the people know where they can find you.
On Facebook as Nick Sullivan, on Instagram, Young Nick, YUNG, 2 underscores, Nick. And on Twitter, Lil Nick, LUHH Nick.
All right, Marlo, you got any last words for the king?
Man, I just want to tell you, man, we appreciate you, man. Appreciate your grind, man. Stay focused. Stay hard, man. Shout out to CJ. Shout out to Mom Dukes, man. All y'all, man. We appreciate y'all, man. And we with you, man, on that goal, on that journey.
Baby,
real talk, man. Appreciate that.
Appreciate you, bro. Appreciate you.
I'm claiming you, little homie. Hey, you on the team, man? You fam, man? Anything?
Real
you
talk.
Any fights, man? Let us know, man. We'll bring you on here. You can let the people know, man. We can get some action behind you, man. Hey, it's real. We rocking with you. I love your style, Young King, man. I'm gonna be checking for you, man. I'm telling everybody that's my little cousin, goddamn. All
right, that's cool. I'm tell him the same thing.
That's what's up.
That's all right,
what we got. I had to stub on these nigga neck. I had to boss up for a check. I had to shoot a nigga for respect. I had to step on these niggas next. Did to show these niggas I got next. I went and put that gold on my neck. I had to show these hoes what they were missing. Bought just every nigga just to kick it.